Welcome to the Outer Rim Rookie, a beginner's journey to joining the 501st. My name's Rob Williams, and I'm here with...
Terry Chu.
Now, we are in a special base. Have we officially chosen the name of this base yet?
All right. No.
No. No. Okay, Dakar. I think that was the name I was thinking, but I don't think that's going to be it. I think we can find a better name. But if you look behind me, this is a new room designed by Terry Chu, and it's got lots of cool geek stuff. I mean... In the comments below, I want you to name all the things from top to bottom. There you go. And if you don't recognize any of these things, I don't even know why you're watching the show here. So, although this one took me just a couple extra seconds here, even though the name tag's right on there. But still, this is not about so much the room. You're going to see lots of it in here. But this is about one of the final steps in designing the armor, and it is the vest. I've been a little bit nervous about this one, but because I'm not a very good scene master. I don't even know what you call the person.
Tailor. Seamstress.
Yeah. Seamstress, tailor, whatever. I'm not very good at sewing. I've gotten so much better, though.
I've
gotten so much better. And to the point where I've been very... In my last video, I talk about how I'm able to just get over the nervousness and just actually try and do it. Accept the mistakes, fix the mistakes. And there's a couple mistakes that even you pointed out to me regarding my belt and stuff like that. In the last video, I showed two rivets on either side of the belt, and it's only supposed to be one on the other side of the belt. And that's a big mistake because I made holes in the actual ABS.
We can fix that.
And we can fix that. This is pretty much, if not the penultimate moment before FanExpo. It could be the last moment before
FanExpo. I think so. Yeah, I think this, today we're going to work on the vest, and if there's any sort of... If we have time, any sort of last-minute tune-ups or tweaks, but this is it.
This is it, because quick rundown of the armor. I've gotten pretty, the armor stuff is done. The shoulders, it just needs a little tweaking here and there. The boots are falling apart a bit. I got to fix the boots. The belt needs to be tightened up. I need your help with some of the straps and stuff like that. Whether that's recorded or not, we'll figure that out. But like I said, the major goal is the vest. And is there anything important for viewers to know when designing the vest?
It's not even like a traditional vest. You kind of put it on like this, almost like an apron, right? Or a bib. It closes in the back. It's going to be a black fabric with raglan sleeves. Mm-hmm. There's a bit of quilting in the on the sleeves, and they only go to your elbows. And that's it.
What's down to the elbows, eh?
Well, you know, a little above. Okay. Not all the way down.
I thought it'd be just like a t-shirt.
Kind of, yeah. So. Yeah.
Okay, great. Well, looking forward to seeing this. And is there a lot of sewing in there?
There's a bit of sewing.
More than the pants.
I think the pants had, you know, when you talk about like thread mileage, mm-hmm. right? There was less thread mileage on the pants, but it was much trickier, right?
The pants I felt was very tricky.
Very curvy shapes and things all over, you know, just compound curves and shapes all over. There's more sewing involved with the vest, but I'd probably put it on par on par with a cummerbund.
Oh, really? Yeah. Okay, it's a lot of straight lines,
lines.
It's very simple in comparison to
sure.
The pants, I sure. thought. So, all right, awesome, let's get to it.
Okay.
Okay, so I'm like a scarecrow here. Terry's kind of making a template for the vest here. He's kind of taped some paper onto me. It's very similar to what you did with the thigh patch. It's just make a template. Eventually, we'll cut the paper to it, I'm assuming. And,
yeah, we'll cut it a little bit bigger, so there's some allowance. And I haven't done it yet, but we're going to add the sleeve here, too. This is going to be a raglan sleeve, so it's going to be like a diagonal sort of seam here. And then there'll be a bunch of like ripped lines that go along the sleeve that are quilted, sort of like the cummerbund.
What's a raglan?
Raglan, it's like a baseball t-shirt. You know how like the chest is sort of white here, but then right here the sleeve is blue or black and it's kind of at an angle? That's a raglan.
Like our t-shirts are sold at T Public, those baseball t-shirts, right? There you go. And a little promo in there. It's awesome.
Cool, yeah. So we're just going to do this, continue. We only need to do the front and the back of one side, and then we're going to flip it for the other sides, right?
Perfect. Let's get it going. All right, so we've got the put together this template. I would like to say it helped, but you were like a man on a mission here. So you've got this template. We were talking about how we're going to do this, and so you decided that we should. Correct me if I'm wrong. This is where the raglan is. You cut here, and then we'll have a sleeve separate. It's because this part is quilted, right?
That's right.
So it'll be like the sleeve, and this part is quilted as well.
Yep.
Okay. So we'll have the sleeve here quilted. That's one piece, and then we'll have this piece here, and then the back as well.
That's right.
Because this rolls over.
Exactly. So. Yeah. So that's the back. It's just you know, obviously because we're tracing it off your coveralls.
Right.
The jumpsuit. It's we're obviously going to make it a little bit bigger because we have to account for the thickness of the fabric. We have to account for the thickness of seams and things like that.
Right.
So, what I like to do is make the separate components, right? And then sew them together, you know, try it on, and then we can always kind of like take it in and adjust it, right?
Yeah.
The front is seamless in terms of the two halves, but the back will have a Velcro closure that'll run up and down from basically the base of your neck down to the middle of your back. And so, you know, we'll have some adjustability there.
Now, you were mentioning also doing it like a pillowcase, but you talked about how this needs to be quilted and it would just be better if we did it in three separate spots.
Yeah, like, I mean, another way to try to do kind of a shirt like this is to not have a separate sleeve, is to make this one piece of fabric, but then you're going to still need two layers for this raglan part, right? So, I mean, it's just as easy to make it a separate piece.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right, so now we're just going to copy this and then...
We're going to transfer that to our fabric and we're going to start sewing pieces together.
All right, let's do it.
So here we are. We have finished sewing one sleeve after a little bit of trial and tribulation. It's a little big here, but this is going to go up more, remember? And also, we can take it in after the fact too, right? I purposely made it a hair big just in case. I always do that.
It's easier to take away than add, pretty much.
Yeah, absolutely.
So this looks really
it's
cool.
It's pretty cool, right?
I love the quilted
look. And there was a bit of weird mind math going on with, like, which side do we draw lines on?
Yeah, we didn't record this, but man, if we could see inside your brain, there's hamsters, there's gerbils, there's Sonic the Hedgehog just spinning around there, working hard too, so.
Cool.
Yeah, so now I guess we have to do the other side.
They make another one. Moment of truth.
Moment of truth. Ready?
Ready?
Okay, let's put this thing on.
Wow, let's put this on. So
let me put the microphone down here.
Sure. Slide that on. Oh,
okay. Oh, thank you, sir.
Maybe turn around and show the... Here's the back closure, right over left. We check the CRL, so there's the Velcro. Trying to stick to itself. Right over left. There we go. A little wrinkly, that's okay. Right?
Yeah, it doesn't feel...
Not too bad, right? We can always take it in a bit, right? Like, we can always sew little darts here and stuff to kind of take this in, just to make it nicey-nice. But it's not going to affect your approval, right? So let's take a look at the... Hey!
How's it look?
Not bad, uh-huh. Right?
There we go.
There you go. The sleeves are a tad long. I like to make stuff just a little long. It's always easier to kind of, take it in after if you absolutely need to. But the original Biker Scouts actually had rolled sleeves mm-hmm. on the vest. They actually, like, tucked them in like this. Right. And so you could do that. Roll it in, like, 2 inches. Right. And then, like, just hand stitch, three or four stitches around. And, you want to be all accurate and stuff. This looks fantastic, right?
This looks really, really good. Right?
So yeah, we can always, take it. But this is an after. This is all hidden, right?
Yeah.
So
the armor, the back arm, everything's just
Really all you're seeing is kind of like the ribbing here. And so we did a great job on the quilting. And
right. Oh my gosh.
This was like the grail piece.
This is the final major piece.
Yeah.
Now everything else is just tweaking, fine-tuning.
Yeah.
Wow.
If we got time before Fan Expo, right? Even if it's like a couple hours, we can kind of just go through and...
And just do the little details.
Yeah, if we just do a little quick coffee meet or something, we could probably get it done, right?
I think so.
Yeah.
This is like now at 98.2%
done. You could literally put it on. You could probably apply with it. And, you got a couple things that just need to be fixed. But you're so close.
Ah,
the tingles.
It's feeling good.
All right.
So that's the vest. It was complicated. You did a lot of work, and because we are on a time crunch right now, but it's just like I was fascinating watching you how you do the math of it. And we were talking about making a teddy bear inside out.
Yeah.
And it was pretty much like that. Treat everything inside out, sew it, and then pop it in around again.
Yeah.
And it looks really good.
Cool.
So. Next is, like we said, the fine tuning, small tweaks, and then Fan Expo.
That's it.
Fan Expo.
So let's maybe find an evening, a couple hours. If you come over, we can be quiet.
Yeah.
My daughter's really.
Yeah.
If there's a noise. You saw the dog in here. There's a little noise, and my dog came running in.
Battery's dying soon, so we better say goodbye.
Thanks.
But thank you. Find us on Panda Props and Costumes on Instagram, as well as
Facebook.
On Facebook, Etsy, all this stuff. Me, Outer Rim Rookie, Generation X-Wing Podcast, and all this sort of stuff. Links down below. Thank you very much. We're almost done, folks. We're almost done. And remember, armor's built on hope. Bye.
Bye. Check the OR, you like it so far. Check the OR, you like it so far. Check the OR, you like it so far. Check the OR, you love the OR. Here we go, ready to set it off. From coast to coast, it's the most and it hits rough. Organized rhymes here to start it up. You got some trouble with your mouth, you better shut it up. Think twice before you act and try to tackle the funky stuff. I take your suckers out like meat on a shish kebab. And you don't know it, but your girl's doing kiss and rob. And you're the one who wants the corn, but you miss the cop. So here's a bit of something new. Give me a toot and salute and I'll give you my boots. Where you need it while I'm playing the thespian. I got a ride and you're just a pedestrian. I grab a horse and I jump like equestrian. I talk smooth like Lando Calrissian.